guys, what's up? Hope you're all doing good out there today. Thanks for tuning back in. And just up here at Lake of the Ozarks, just got off the water filming a promotional video for the new jig that I'm designing for Baitworks. I've been talking about this a little bit, guys. It's probably going to be coming out in a couple weeks. I'm so excited about this. We're putting together a really good video on it. This jig's sort of an accumulation of the 45 years of jig fishing experience I've got. There's things I've always wanted in a jig that I couldn't find before. We got it right. We got it tweaked. Pretty excited about it. And I'll let you guys know when we put the video up. But anyway, what I wanted to do today, I want to do a mid-season review on my new Skeeter FXR 20, 2021 boat, 20-foot model. I've had a chance to fish out a lot. You know, if you guys followed me last year, I fished out of the ZXR and I went to the FXR this year, and I'm gonna go through head to toe every part that's on this boat and let you guys have an honest assessment of what I think about this. So
okay,
here
guys,
we go.
Let's start at the front and work our way back. Like I said, the hitch set up here, nice, clean and neat, very easy to use, very efficient. I love that. Love the step here. This is super handy launching the boat. You know, you don't get your feet wet. And this, the step ups here, you just can't beat these. You can actually step up in the boat from the step ins and not have to get your feet wet. Great winch on here. I really like the wheel on it is an upgrade. This is a different system. The thing's super smooth. You don't have to put a lot of pressure on it to get the wheel up. So I really, really like that. Got the Minn Kota 112 Ultrex. This year, this is the third year I've run the Ultrex. To be honest with you guys, I've had a lot of problems with the Ultrex in the past. I haven't had any problems this year. Been really fortunate with that. But really good motor. Like I said, I don't get any type of deal on these things. I've been giving you guys an honest assessment. Spot lock is invaluable in a lot of different situations. Got the Hummingbird Helix 12 unit on there. Actually, guys, this has got side imaging and down imaging, but all I really use is 2D sonar. I mean, I'd be fine with the 2D sonar unit and a GPS, but the 12-inch screen is really nice. You can see it easy. Foot pedal switch there. I've got my power pole foot switches right there. Okay, the trailer on the thing's really cool. Nice solid trailer, fiberglass fenders, and these tires here, guys. See how wide those things are? Those things track, these tires track so good when you're pulling it down the highway. There's something about the width of the tires that I really, really like on this boat. Storage compartments, this is the big difference on here. On the ZXR, you had the split storage up front here. I did not like the way that was set up because it was sort of awkward. You had to split down the middle. They folded this way and that way, but this particular storage folds straight up. Excellent storage, nice deep rod lockers on both sides. Got a nice little dry box there, use that a lot. Another little day box here, just nice for stuff. It's got the new, I'm not sure what do you guys call this thing. It's the new rubberized mat carpet. This is a great, great feature on the FXR. You know how hard it is to get your carpet to dry out on the floor here. Don't have to worry about this. It's dry in a matter of minutes once it quits raining. Fishing right now, but you can hose it off. It's really nice there. These seats, guys, are unbelievable. The seats on the FXR series, super, super comfortable, super, super smooth. You don't get jarred around, bounced around in the boat. Absolutely love the seats. Nice, great live well system, nice deep live wells. Another deep storage there. Got all my battery storage back in here. I'm running five batteries. I've got three cranking and three Dakota lithium for my trolling motor. Never run out of power with them. Then I've got two cranking batteries for all my extra electronics and pumps and that, so I never run out. Nice little day box here. It's a nice new feature, the FXR. Got the 10-inch offset jack plate this year, the hydraulic. Really love this. Hydraulic plate, guys, is really worth the investment. For the money that you spend on it, there's a lot of things you can do about it. A hydraulic plate will get you out of a lot of problems. You can jump logs with it. You can idle over extended periods of flats with it. You know, it's just super, super efficient if you fish a lot of, you know, really shallow water. And you can adjust the ride based upon how rough it is. Here's the ladder. To be honest with you guys, I'm not real crazy about this ladder. This thing,
I like the compactness of it. I mean, I don't like just a regular ladder. It's a little bit more difficult to get up into than a regular ladder, but I usually just jump up on the side anyway there. I mean, I don't ever use a ladder when we're swimming, but this thing is for somebody that is like maybe really overweight or out of shape. This is a little bit more difficult to use than a regular one. Got my 2 8-foot blade power poles on there. Can't do without them. Those blade power poles are a lifesaver, fishing shallow water, docking your boat, anything like that. If you're fishing around docks, you can trim the things down and it keeps your boat from getting scratched up. The new Yamaha 250 SHO, this thing is freaking awesome. It's new cowling, as you can see, super, super sharp. These things, all you do is turn them on and go. There's nothing to worry about. Bulletproof. I've just absolutely loved this Yamaha motor. It's been absolutely one of the best motor I've ever seen. The console, this is a big difference right here from the FX, from the ZXR, is you've got the LED gauges instead of the toggles on there, which I really like. Nice and simple on there. Again, a nice, clean, simple dashboard. Love that. It's got a radio you can see right there in it, which I never use. You guys know I don't use radios even in my truck, so that's one feature I don't use. And I've got, again, the Hummingbird Helix 12 on the console. I like having the exact same unit on the front and the console. Say, for example, if one of them goes out, I can switch it back and forth, and I'm not dead in the water without electronics. So pretty simple deal. The hull, guys, this hull on this boat, it's absolutely the best hull I have ever rowed in rough water. I think this is the same hull that comes on the ZXR. I think the only difference is the interior layout, but this thing drives like a little sports car. It's super great. If you're in like 2 to 3 foot chops, you know, which we have a lot if the wind's blowing 20-25, it just does not jar you. It doesn't, you know, kill your back. It's nice and smooth. The design really cuts those waves really, really nice underneath there. And a super fast boat, fastest boat I've ever had. This boat will run over 70 any day, all day long. I'm super, super happy with the
whole setup. Go, guys. New Skeeter FXR. Awesome, awesome boat. If you guys are interested, come on down to Boatwork, Springfield, Missouri. They have financing there available through Summit Financing. If you use the financing through Boatworks, and you mention my name, you get a $100 gift certificate to the Baitworks Tackle Store that's right there next door to Boatworks. Great, great company. These guys are all these guys that own the company, they fish too, just like you and I do. Take care of you with your service. It's just an awesome, awesome place to get one. So hope you guys enjoyed the review, and we'll see y'all later.